Multi-junction based solar cells, they have the highest efficiency of solar energy conversion among all all solar cell devices. So depending upon how many junctions you use, whether you use two junctions, three junctions, or four junctions, the efficiency of these multi-junction cells, they can be, you know, upward of 40% for this energy conversion easily. And also another thing I know is that these multi-junction cells, they work best when you operate them at high concentration, or you operate them at a concentration of 500x or 1000x or even higher. So in this video, I want to understand this very important question, is that how does the temperature coefficient of the efficiencies for these multi-junction cell looks like, or how does the efficiencies of these multi-junction cells degrade as I increase, as there's an increase in the temperature of the ambient or increase in the temperature of the device. And this is a very pertinent question, and it's a very relevant question for these multi-junction cells, especially since I operate them at this very high concentration, and these are often placed in regions which have a very high direct incident sunlight, and they are usually placed in regions which have higher temperature profiles, such as deserts and so on. This is where you expect high concentration of direct sunlight. So the ambient temperature in those places, of course, is supposed to be higher as well. So I want to know whether this efficiency, the high efficiency that these solar cells have, will essentially just evaporate if I increase the temperature, or what will happen. So the first thing I want to look at is the open circuit voltage. And in one of the previous videos, we studied that this open circuit voltage, it degrades as you increase the temperature of your device. And this is what causes essentially a decrease in the efficiency of the cell. And I can represent that decrease in the VOC by a set of mathematical equations. So if I represent my, if I can represent my current due to generation and recombination by this equation, where the temperature dependence is given by this power dependence, and also it occurs due to this exponential term over here. And then I can express my open circuit voltage. I can express it as this formula, where it depends upon the log of my short circuit current divided by this I0 1, which is given by this equation. So then I can take a derivative of that. I can take a derivative of that and essentially calculate my temperature dependent of VOC. And it's usually comes out to be this formula, where this VOC, it has this negative term, this temperature dependence of VOC, it has a negative term. So this VOC degrades as I increase my temperature. And also I see that this degradation of VOC, it depends on the difference between, my band gap and my open circuit voltage. So the higher is my open circuit voltage, the smaller is the difference between the band gap and the open circuit voltage. And the slower is the rate of degradation of this open circuit voltage. So a good thing about these multi-junction cells is that they're operated at these high concentrations at this 500x or 1000x. As a result of that, I know that when I increase the concentration of my light, my VOC increases, because my short circuit current, it accordingly increases by 500 times or 1000 times. As a result of that, my VOC, essentially it has this logarithmic dependence on this short circuit current, so it increases. And that bodes good news for this VOC, you know, this VOC, temperature coefficient of VOC, because now my VOC is higher. As a result of that, this difference between my band gap and VOC is lower, so my VOC essentially degrades at a much slower rate. And this can be seen nicely in this table over here, which tabulates these different, for these different kind of cells, the VOC, the rate of change of the VOC, and you know, the rate of the change of VOC as a percentage of the VOC. So this tells me how much percentage of degradation I have in my open circuit voltage for every Kelvin increase in my temperature. So I noticed that for this multi-junction cell, so for example, for this three-junction multi-junction cell, which is very prevalent, which is germanium, gallium arsenide, and indium gallium phosphide, I see that my VOC it degrades by this 0.23% when I'm operating the device as a concentration of 1 sun. But now when I increase the concentration to 500 sun, or when I'm operating this as a concentration of 500x, then I see that this rate of the degradation of VOC it reduces from this 0.23 to 0.15. So if I am operating my device at higher concentration, this rate of degradation of VOC it essentially slows down. Now the other thing I am interested in is how does my short circuit current or my JSC behaves as a function of temperature. And this is very interesting because I've mentioned this what happens in the case of a single junction cell. Let me repeat it here. So if I have a single junction cell, if I have only this one material system, when I essentially increase the temperature, the band gap of the cell decreases. As a result of that, it can now absorb more of the polar spectrum. So for example, this cell was only marginally absorbing the green light, but now since its band gap has decreased, it can absorb more of this green light. And as a result of that, this JSC typically increases as you increase your temperature. But this becomes very interesting if you have for example, a multi-junction cell. So let's say I had another cell below it. So I had another cell below it, and let's say I have one more cell below it. So among these three cells, it's usually one cell which limits the overall short circuit current of my overall circuit. So let's say in this case it was the top cell which was limiting the overall short circuit current. So now when I heat up when I heat up the cell, or when the ambient temperature rise, the band gap of all these three cell will decrease as the temperature increases. So as the band gap of this top cell decreases, its JSC will rise. And you would expect that for these bottom cells, the JSC should rise as well. But there's a very interesting relationship over here. So the JSC of this cell is rising because the band gap of this top cell is decreasing. So it is absorbing more of these photons. So that means these cells which are located below it, they now see less of the spectrum because more of it is being absorbed by this top cell. So as a result of that, which of these cells is limiting the short circuit current can change as a function of temperature. For example, in this case, maybe it was the top cell which was limiting the current. But now since the JSC of the top cell rises, it may be the middle cell which limits my overall current. And this is shown very nicely over here. So this shows that it shows the short circuit current of this individual cells in a two cell configuration. So when I was at lower temperature, my top cell had lower current, so it was limiting the current. But when I increase the temperature, I see there's a crossover here, and now my top cell has more current as compared to my bottom cell, and my bottom cell becomes the cell which is limiting the overall current in my device. So that gives a very nice, interesting functional dependence of the short circuit current. And this short circuit current, it increases as a function of temperature. But since which of these cells is limiting the overall current can change, so this temperature dependence of JSC, it can essentially have this step profile when this crossover happens. But nonetheless, the JSC on a whole, it increases as you increase your temperature. So the efficiency degradation of these multi-junction solar cells is often touted to be one of the best among all the different solar cells. So these CPV cells are these multi-junction cells which are used under these concentration of very high concentration of 1000x or 500x. Their VOC essentially it reduces at a much lower pace as compared to all the other cells. As a result of that, the efficiency degradation of these cells happens only between, it ranges between, to be very optimistic, between 0.05 to around 0.15 percentage decrease in the efficiency, with per 1% with every centigrade increase in the temperature. So if I had this cell and it was operating at 100% of its plate capacity at normal temperature, when I increase the temperature by 20 C, or if I increase the temperature by 40 C, even if I increase the temperature by 40 C, it still give me 96% of this efficiency that it was delivering at normal temperature. Versus if I compare this to a mono silicon, or single crystalline silicon, it would only deliver around 84% of that nameplate capacity at with the 40 C increase in the temperature. Polycrystalline is even worse. It delivers only 80%. Some of the thin film technologies actually fare better, and we'll talk about that in a later video. But they have temperature coefficients which are better than single crystalline silicon. But nonetheless, these multi-junction solar cells, which are used under concentration of light, they have the best temperature coefficient of efficiency. And that's a good news, because these cells are the ones which have highest efficiency, and they're usually placed in conditions where you have the largest change in the operating temperature. So it's good to know that the efficiency does not degrade as rapidly.